Hi everyone, welcome back to the second video on Lesson 1, Level 1. In this video, we'll learn how to create headers and correct various types of errors that we'll commonly encounter. Let's continue from where we left off on Lesson 1 in the previous video.
First off, I'm going to add a title to the spreadsheet. You should always have some type of identification on the spreadsheet. There are two ways of thinking of a header in Excel. One way is to look at it from a printing perspective. If you want your data portion here to be clear of any extra header-related text and just want the header to be visible on a printed copy, click here on View. See how Normal is currently selected? Change this to Page Layout and see how your page would show you a header area. You can add different things to the left, center, and right area of the header. Let's take a look at some of the pre-made options for you up here in the Header Footer Design tab. Here under the header, there are a bunch of pre-made choices. If you want a little more control, most of these choices are out here on the ribbon. Let's add the sheet name to the left and page 1 of 1 here on the right. You can also add some custom text anywhere you want. Here in the middle, let's add, Ken's Awesome Title. Notice that you also have all the same options on the page footer. If you want to see what this looks like when printing, go back to the page layout on the main ribbon and click on this little more icon. Here are a lot of the same options, along with a print preview button. Ta-da! Let's look at the header from non-printing or visible on-screen perspective. The first thing that I'm going to do is to add a header above everything else. It turns out that we do not have any room, so I'm going to add one row above the first row. We can do that by clicking the row number and then right-clicking on it and then clicking Insert. This will create a new row. Now I can type in the sheet title. If I want that title to appear above and be aligned with all the columns in the data, I'll have to merge all of these five cells into one large cell. You can easily do this by clicking on the Merge and Center button. This button will take those five cells and merge them into one, and then center the data in the middle of this new big cell. You can also unmerge the cells later if need be. Let's continue on making this page error-free. If you scroll down a bit, you'll notice that this total of 36 is not quite correct. By the appearance of things, it looks like the math in this cell is somehow broken. If you visually add up the values displayed in these cells, they add up to 34, but this formula is somehow calculating a sum of 36. What's up with that? The problem here is that even when I look at the formula in this cell, which I can reveal by double-clicking it or clicking once on it and then clicking the formula bar up here, you can see that it's adding up the values in these four cells. So the problem's not in the formula. If you select all of the cells that you want to add up, take a look down here and show yourself some values that Excel 365 calculates for you. See here we have the average, count, the sum of these four cells, and even this formula thinks the answer is 36. The problem is what we're actually looking at in these four cells. The formatting of these cells is all screwed up so that it does not reveal the entire number contained in the cell in the first place. This cell is formatted to show you nothing to the right of the decimal point, but if we look up here in the formula bar, the actual number is 24.2292. The same is here in the cells below. We see a whole number integer of 2, but the data is actually 2.49. We can keep on going and hopefully notice that what's happening here. The formula is correctly adding up these incorrectly formatted numbers, so what do we do to fix this? There's a very short and quick, easy way to figure out what's in each cell and not just what we're seeing is to use the Control plus the tilde key. The tilde key is the number next to the number 1 on the keyboard. Now hold down the Control and finally the tilde key. This reveals the entire numbers as they actually exist in the cell. This also reveals all your formulas too. To correct this error, I'm just going to add to the precision of the display of these cells. I'm going to change the format by using the accounting format, which gives us two decimal places. If I didn't want to do that, Control-Z, Control-Z, I could increase the decimal places and reveal more of the underlying data. Since these values are actually money, I'll use the accounting format over all these cells, and then remove the dollar signs from all but the first row and the total line down here. Finally, before we finish this segment, let me show you a common issue that we run into in Excel that confuses a lot of folks. Out here in columns H and I, I've hidden some goodies. Let me highlight these surrounding columns, and then I'll right-click on them, unhide. There you are. I have a customer here with this great big customer ID, and then a bunch of sales numbers here underneath that ID. If I want to sum these numbers, I'll use a sum function, right? There's actually only one formula in all of Excel that's tied to a keyboard shortcut. And guess what? Yep, it's the sum formula. If I come down here and hit Alt plus the equal sign, this creates a sum function here, and it tries to guess what cells you want to sum. I don't want to add in the customer ID up here since I just want to sum the sales. I can either fix the equation by dragging the range down by one or fixing the cell reference up here in the formula bar. Either way is fine with me. Okay, so unfortunately now I have this pesky green warning down here. What's up with that? If I look at this warning, I see that it tells me that my formula omits adjacent cells. Excel is smart enough to see that I have this range of numbers in my formula, and there's another number that I didn't include right next to it. Did I do this on purpose? Well, yeah, I did. Leave me alone, you crazy Excel programming geeks. I know what I'm doing. I can either select the drop-down list and select Ignore the Error, and that little green thing goes away, or I can just throw my nose up in the air and take solace in the fact that I know what I'm doing, and I'm going to leave it there just to taunt people. All right, well, I think that's enough for this video. I'll see you in Level 2.